You've had some time now to plan your engineering design challenge. Were you successful? Did you show your teacher how you decided to separate the materials? Let's get back to our classroom to compare your results to those of our students.
Team 1, how did you do with this engineering design challenge?
Our plan was to do the separation one step at a time. We don't know what the big pellets are made out of, but we noticed that the magnets didn't affect them. We found out that the magnets pulled out the dark particles, so we guessed that they were iron.
So we pushed the magnets around in the sand to get the iron out. I think we got all of it. We just picked up the bigger metal pellets with our fingers.
Okay, those big pellets were made of zinc. And there are other ways to separate zinc than using your fingers, but for now, their method worked. Anything else?
Sure, the styrofoam floated on top, so we used the cheesecloth to separate that.
That meant the beaker had water, sand, and a dissolved white powder, maybe sugar or salt. We poured the water into the other beaker, leaving most of the wet sand behind.
We put the beaker of water on top of the hot plate to evaporate the water out, and we saw what looks like salt crystallized on the sides of the beaker.
Good thinking. Let's count how many items you separated. Zinc pellets, iron filing, styrofoam, salt, sand, and some water. And the rest of the water evaporated into the air. Good job. And you did this in how many steps?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 steps.
Okay. Now, let's hear from the other team.
We tried some things that were different and some of the same things. We pulled out the big zinc pellets with our fingers, and we added water to get the styrofoam pieces out, too.
We decided to tape the magnets on the tube, and then pour the iron, sand, and salt mixture down the tube to trap the iron filings on the way down.
Did it work?
I don't think we got all the iron out. Then we fixed the ring stand so all the water would pour through a funnel that we lined with this cloth.
The cloth seemed to catch most of the sand, but some of the sand got stuck in the tube. To separate the salt and the water, we heated the water on the hot plate so the water evaporated, leaving the salt behind.
We tried to catch the water using a piece of glass so the water would condense. The water dripped a lot, so we had a hard time getting the glass turned so we could catch the water in a beaker.
That was a good try. You separated zinc, styrofoam, iron, sand, salt, and water. You separated 5 materials. You now have a chance to revise and design and try again tomorrow when I'll grade your work with the Engineering Design Challenge rubric. Plan together, and remember, you can change your procedures as long as you only use the equipment that's here. Get together with your partner and start revising your plan.
Our teams did a really great job of separating all those materials. Now they have a chance to redesign their procedures, just like scientists and engineers do. You should try this challenge again yourself and see if you can develop a better separation method on your second try. You now know about physical and chemical properties of matter, physical and chemical changes, phase changes of solids, liquids, and gases, mixtures, and common separation methods. And you got to show off your creativity with an engineering design challenge. But before we wrap this unit up, let's go back to where we started for a minute, the very top of this unit, when I mentioned that the water molecules you're drinking today may be the same molecules that were in her toilet a few weeks ago. And for a better understanding of that, I spoke with Stan Brinkley, who's a treatment division manager at the Cobb County Marietta Water Authority. Thank you for joining us, Stan. Now tell us what it is you do at the Cobb County Marietta Water Authority.
I'm the plant manager of the Corals Water Treatment Plant. We're an 86 million gallon a day conventional treatment plant, and we supply most of the water for Cobb County.
Great. And how did you get interested in this line of work?
Well, I actually, my first promotion from an operator to the lab was because I had had high school chemistry.
Nice. So tell us about how water is delivered to plants that purify our drinking water.
Well, in our case, we take the water out of the Chattahoochee River and bring it to the plant to treat it. It's a 4-step process, conventional treatment. The first step is coagulation, and we add a chemical to the water that actually coagulates and takes all the dirt particles out of the water, separates them. The second step of that is flocculation. In that step, the particles that we have separated, we actually build them up to a bigger mass so that they will actually have weight and settle out. And the next step, which is sedimentation. So in the sedimentation basin over time, all those particles that we've formed then settle out and fall to the bottom of the basin. We have a clean water that comes then to the filters to be filtered.
So our students just did a filtration exercise, so that should be familiar with that concept.
That's right. So after the filters, it filters any of the suspended matter out and the oxidized metals and things out of the water. So once it gets through that, it's clean drinking water.
Great.
And then we add chlorine to the water to disinfect it so that it's safe to drink.
Now, tell us about the tests that are done at your plant to make sure it's safe to drink in our homes.
Well, our plant operators are there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and every hour they're performing chemical tests on the water. They check for chlorine residuals, they check for pH, they check for iron and manganese, they check for fluoride residual that helps the dental in children.
Mm-hmm.
So there's somebody there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to ensure that the water's safe to drink.
So that is good, clean water.
Good, clean water.
That's great. Now, let's talk a little bit about wastewater, because that's different. How is wastewater delivered to treatment facilities?
Well, wastewater is collected at the homes, and it goes to a wastewater plant. And there they do a different process, but they basically take all the solids and material out of the water, and the water that's the leaves that plant then goes into a receiving stream and goes back into a stream or a river or something, mm-hmm. and back into the natural watershed.
Now, is the, say, rainwater from the street treated the same way that wastewater from our homes is?
No, typically the rainwater goes into what's called stormwater.
Okay.
And it just pipes that water into a creek or something, and it runs back into the river and enters the waterway that way.
Okay. Now, a lot of people, they drink bottled water because they feel like it's safer or whatever. What do you think about that?
Well, all the water from the water treatment plants passes all the federal regulations, so it is perfectly safe to drink, and there's no reason not to be drinking your tap water.
And we can't say that about bottled water, necessarily.
Well, bottled water is not regulated by anybody. So
no comment about bottled water. But definitely tap water is good to go.
Tap water is good to go.
Excellent. And just goes to show that chemistry matters.
That's right.
Right? Great. Well, thank you so much for joining us. A lot of great information.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed this introduction to matter. Join me for Unit 3 of our Chemistry Matters series, Atomic Structure.